Hello everybody. In this video, we're going to go over the hands-on task of adding accessible text and multimedia to a Canvas page. So to do this, we're going to go in our sandbox course. And if you want, you can add it straight into your module here, or you can go to pages and click on pages and then add it there. For this, I'm going to add it into one of the pre-existing modules that I've been working on. So for my first module, I'm going to go to the right, click the little plus, and where it says assignment, I'm going to click on that and change it to page. And this is going to be a new page, and I will title this Accessible Page, just so I can find it easier later, and then select Add Item. And there it is. I'm going to click on these and just drag it to the top of the module. Usually I have a page first and then followed by the other items in my module. Now that I have this created, I'm going to click on it because it's currently empty, as you can see, and then Edit, upper right corner. Now the title is going to be a heading 1. So that's automatically set for us. But we are going to add another heading here, a subheading from the title. So if this were a page about how to make an accessible page, you would maybe call it that, how to create an accessible page. So this is going to be the topic of this particular page. I'm going to then highlight this sentence. You'll see in the rich content editor, I have the word paragraph here. If you select paragraph, you can change it to these different formats. And we have heading 2, heading 3, heading 4, and so on. So I'm going to select for this one, header 2, and then click back inside and click return on my keyboard. And you'll see that now it says paragraph again. So Canvas is smart. It knows what we want to do. Part of accessibility, if you're going to create lists, you don't want to just do 1 and then type it out, 2, type it out. Screen readers can't read that as a list. So if you do want to add a list, I suggest using either one of these little items in the editor. So this one is a bullet list, and then right to the right of it is a numbered list. So we're going to click on numbered list, and you'll see that throws the little number 1 in there for me. So I'm going to just for step 1, we'll say go to pages. And then when I click enter or return on my keyboard, it automatically gives me the number 2. And I can say click plus page, 3, edit page, and add headers. 4, we're going to just say use the accessibility checker. Okay, and I spelled accessibility wrong. That's all right. You know, this is just for fun. We're not really going to write out all the steps, but I just wanted to show you how to create an accessible list. And let's say I had another part of this page that was how to create an accessible video. Let's say I also had that information. Again, because this is kind of on equal footing with this header up here, I would again make this a header too by highlighting it and selecting header 2. And then I could again do a list, or I could have little subtopics. I could talk about captioning, right? Captioning. And then also I could talk about use of color. If I wanted to, if these were subheadings of this section here, I could make these heading 3s. And that way we would be going heading 1 at the top, heading 2 for each of these main topics, And then heading 3 for subtopics. And you can kind of see how that goes. So I'm going to make both of those header 3s. And then under captioning, this is a paragraph you'll see up here. And this would be content about captioning. And then etc. Use of color. This could be content about color. All right, so this is kind of getting some structure here. And now we're going to upload an image. So we'll go, there's a couple ways to do this. I'm gonna go over to this embed image symbol, click on that. You have some options here. You could put a URL. You could, if you had an image file uploaded to Canvas, you'd select Canvas. And then you have Flickr, which is kind of fun. You can just search for Flickr. So I'm going to search for accessibility. I always spell that wrong. Accessibility symbol. Let's just see if it comes up here. And it doesn't. So that's not a good example. But we will use, let's use this bronze bull. Let's just use that. And you can see when I select that image over here of this chart, it actually already has the alt text in there. It says Charging Bull, New York City. I might add Charging Bull Bronze Statue, New York City. Or you could even add, you know, outside of Wall Street. You could add anything you wanted in here. You just want it to give the student kind of the gist of what that picture is. So once you've got that alt text in, you also have the option to check it off as a decorative image. If this image is not important, if it doesn't really have any purpose other than looking nice, then you can select decorative image. You can adjust dimensions here. I prefer to adjust them in Canvas. So I'm going to click on update here. And you can see there's that image. If you click on it, you will get these handles where you can make it bigger or smaller. You can always come back later if you want to change the alt text. Just go into edit in the page, click on it, and then click on that embed image rich content editor icon. And then you can change the alt text again if you want later. Now we have an image. So I'm going to show you how to put a video in there. I like using TED Talk videos because they are already pretty good. They normally have the captioning on them because they're made for education. So a lot of these videos in here are already good. If you're using YouTube, you definitely want to preview the video with the captions on to make sure that they are good quality captions for your students. If the video doesn't have captions, I don't recommend using it. I recommend looking for a different video that has captions on it. So I'm going to pick TED Ed in this case, and we are going to search for economy. There we go. Since we have the bull there, we might as well keep it on the same topic. So here's a video, How Economic Inequality Harms Societies. I'm going to say that that's the video I want, so I'll click on embed. And there it is. I'm going to watch a little bit of it just to make sure the captions are correct. Okay, so there's the captions. And they're okay. They do have some problems with the fact that they don't have punctuation as far as periods and such. But they look okay. There is capitals and stuff like that. And I can read what he's saying. So I'm going to say that this is okay for this exercise. So there's the image, there's the video, there's the text with the headers. I have a list in there. I could also do a link. I'm just going to show you, even though this isn't part of the exercise, I want to show you the best practice of creating links in here. So let's say I wanted a link to the college library. I'm going to actually open a new tab up at the top, and I'm going to find the library. So I'm going to go to my college here, and I'm just going to try to find the link that I want. And this could be a link anywhere. This could be a link to an article in the New York Times. It could be anything. Library, where is it? Here's the library services. Let's see. I want the library homepage. So here we are. We're on the library homepage. And if I look up here in the upper left, there it is, westla.edu/library/index, right? So I'm going to copy that link. And I'm going to come back to my Canvas tab where I have my page open. So what I'm going to do is something called a natural language link, where I'm going to say this is going to be the WLAC library website. I'm just going to call it that. The thing you don't want to call it is link to or click here. That is not good, because that doesn't tell the student where that link is going. It just says click here, and then it'll read out some nonsense. So now that I've written out kind of exactly where that link's going to go, I've highlighted it, and then we're going to go back to the top, to the rich content editor, and I'm going to click on this link to URL. This little looks like a chain link, and this is where I'm going to paste that link. That's not nice, not easy on the eyes. And then if I click insert link, you'll see there it is, and that's a little easier for a student to understand. So now that we have all of the items, we have the headers, we have the list, we have the image with the alt text and the video and the link, the last thing to do is to click on this little accessibility checker right here. It looks like a little person in a circle, and we want to click on that, and we want those balloons to show up. And you can see it says no accessibility issues were detected. And that's what you want to see. If there were issues, it would tell you them and tell you how to fix them. It's not perfect, but it's pretty good, and it can save you some headaches later on. So use that little checker when you can. So now that that's good, I'm going to click save, and then we can copy the link to this page and go turn it in the course. And that's it. Thanks for watching.